When is not a backdoor just a backdoor? Australia's struggle with encryption. The federal government has announced it will seek to introduce new laws to force companies to help Australian security agencies access encrypted messages from suspected terrorists and other criminals. But just how it proposes to do this is unclear. Attorney General George Brandis has insisted the government doesn't want backdoor access to secure messaging apps. But, as many have pointed out, it's hard to see any tool that gives law enforcement privileged access to otherwise encrypted messages as anything else but a backdoor. How end-to-end encryption works, backdoor or not, it's worth being skeptical of any mechanism aimed at accessing encrypted messages on platforms like WhatsApp. To explain why, you need to understand how end-to-end encrypted messaging services work. Encrypted messaging servers scramble the original message, the plain text, into something that looks like random gibberish, the ciphertext. It's about more than just encryption. The government wants to get its hands on baddies' communications. Will it be via a weakening of encryption or a more sneaky method, like getting the tech companies to help? Check out the ABC's new podcast Tell Me Straight. Translating it back to plain text on the receiver's phone depends on a key, a short string of text or numbers. Without access to the key, it isn't feasible to get the plain text back. Keys are generated in pairs, a public key and a private key, of which only the private key must be kept secure. The sender of the secure message has the receiver's public key, which is used to encrypt the plain text. The public key cannot be used to unscramble the ciphertext, nor does possessing the public key help in obtaining the private key. End-to-end encryption simply keeps the private key securely stored on the phones themselves, and converts the ciphertext to plain text directly on the phone. Neither the private keys nor the plain text are ever available to the operator of the messaging service. Compromising security, an encrypted messaging app could hypothetically be modified in a number of ways to make it easier for authorities to access. One would be to restrict the range of keys that the app can generate. That would make it possible for governments to check all possibilities. The U.S. government, which imposed regulations to this effect for a brief period in the 1990s, may have once had computing resources far in excess of any other entity, but this is no longer the case. In fact, these old rules are themselves still causing security problems, as some applications can be tricked into reverting to the insecure export mode encryption that is trivially crackable today. Photo: once a backdoor became known, users might switch services or even make their own. Reuters, Nacho Dos. Other national governments and well-funded private bodies would find brute force checking of all the possible keys well within their capabilities, compromising the security of legitimate users. And while governments might believe they can keep their back door secure, such secrets have a nasty habit of leaking out, as did hacking techniques used by the CIA and NSA. Nor can governments simply make possessing encryption software a criminal offense. Take the application Pretty Good Privacy, PGP, or, more precisely, its open source equivalent GNU Privacy Guard, GPG. Once used for securing email messages, it's now more often used to ensure software updates on Linux systems are from the original authors and have not been tampered with. For instance, the system update tool in Ubuntu Linux uses the GPG machinery for this. Without it, the Linux servers that run much of the internet would become much more vulnerable to hackers. Similar mechanisms are used in Windows, iOS, and Android to prevent compromised applications from being installed. As such, banning or undermining end-to-end encryption would seriously affect internet security. Endless workarounds in any case. Creating backdoors in end-to-end encrypted messaging services would not achieve its goals. Once messaging app backdoors became known, savvy users would simply switch to another service, or make their own. Most popular secure messaging apps, such as WhatsApp and Facebook's Secure Messaging Mode, use a system originally developed by OpenWhisper Systems for the Signal Secure Messaging app. Anyone can download the source code and set up their own version. Photo: George Brandis says encryption is one of the greatest challenges in law enforcement today. ABC News, Marco Catalano, If the Australian government was somehow able to force users to use messaging apps that the government could access, it would impose a minor inconvenience on those wishing to communicate securely but little more. It would be possible to develop a separate encryption app that encrypts the message. Using digital steganography, the encrypted message could be hidden within a photo or video file. This could then be sent as an attachment. The government's access to the messaging app would then be moot. While they may with some effort be able to discover the existence of the hidden messages in media file attachments, they would still be unable to decrypt the message. To date, the ideas floated by the Australian and British governments on end-to-end encryption could most charitably be described as vague. They would be wise to consult experts to come up with proposals grounded in technical reality if they wish to be taken seriously by the technology industry. Robert Merkel is a lecturer in software engineering at Monash University. This piece was originally published in The Conversation and has been adapted with the author's permission.